Hey guys, and welcome to First Impressions. This is a feature on the YouTube channel that is essentially dedicated to uncovering new resources. These are applications that have been heavily requested by you guys, or applications that have been in the news recently. We're going to basically dissect them, giving you the features and a general impression of these applications. Now, for a lot of the time, these will be my first experience with the application, so you guys can see my general snags and issues with it, and also the things that I particularly love about the application, so you can get all of the insight that you need to know to make out that decision if it's for you. If you have an app that you want to request, you can use the form below, enter it, and we'll definitely take it into consideration. We've got a few lined up, so the next few weeks are going to be covered, but as you can imagine, I'll check the form every time I choose a video. So guys, today we are looking at Amazin Marvin, which is an application a lot of you guys have requested a review on in the Facebook group. And what I want to do today is review this application. Now, Marvin is essentially a to-do list application with a few hidden perks. We're going to go over the features, then dive into the pricing, and I'll give you my first impressions. So guys, just before we dive in, I wanted to thank SaneBox, which is the sponsor for this month here on Keep Productive YouTube channel. SaneBox, for those who don't know, is an email management solution that would allow you to reduce email in your inbox. Whether you use Spark, Missive, or many of the other email applications, it works with every single client and works away in the background to clear any unnecessary emails and also sort out things like newsletters, mailing lists that will also save you a lot of time. I'll talk about SaneBox a little later. You can get $25 discount below. So guys, let's dive into Marvin. Now, this is Marvin in front of us. Marvin is an application that is only available really for web right now. They do have mobile versions and they're working on revisions. The team is very small. There's only two of them, Christina and her husband. They are basically working on this application at the moment, but they do very much listen to the community. That's something that I've noticed. They've got a Facebook group for when you become a subscriber with them that will help you to request features and etc. So this application works in premise like a to-do list application. You can go to the top and naturally add a to-do. So for example, it could be a film YouTube video and you press enter and naturally it gets added to different sections that you're working on. But the great thing is with this application, and I say the real magic, is that it allows you to add your own experiences. So for example, you can switch on or switch off different features, which is something that a lot of people like about Marvin. So as you can see here, this is the dashboard you get, and there is an area in the top right-hand corner called Strategies, where you will access all of that. And that's basically like switch on, switch off mode for all of these additional features. Now, before we dive into that, I did play around with this before. There is something called a master list, and this really takes the premise of all of your tasks. So for example, as you can see here, this is the master list. You have the ability to create projects. You have the ability to create folders, which are essentially areas, and also the ability to create tasks naturally. So for example, if I wanted to plan my day ahead, I create a few dummies here, but let's say I've got a task today that is specific to one client. So I'm gonna say client A, I actually need to finish the main document for it, if I can spell it right. And as you can see here, once you add a task, it is like any other to-do list application. You can essentially get it there. You can add notes to it. You can schedule for a specific date. So I'm actually going to schedule it for today. And you can edit the task. Like normal, you can actually choose a specific due date for it. So you don't necessarily have to add a due date. You can add a start date and a due date, which will add to the abilities of the task. If you want to add specific subtasks, you can do so here and delete it from this window too. Now, this is good in premise. You could essentially just go to this and start adding loads of tasks and projects and folders. And that's great. A lot of people like to do that. You can see this list view as well here. A lot of people like doing that. You can also configure the view in different ways. But let's just come out of this a second, because this is where the real magic is. If you click plan my day, it will essentially open this sidebar up here where you can access the master list. And I'm on master list now. If I scroll down to freelance, you can see inside of freelance, I have this task, but it's already associated to the actual day that I put it on. So you can see in front of you, you have sort of a few tasks and naturally you can move them around. You can even add specific times and dates to them. Now, that's really cool because once you can start planning your day in terms of like dragging stuff in and plotting it out, it becomes really valuable and a lot of people like to do that. Now, you have a few basic filtering abilities. You can filter by category, section, recurring, whether the task is a recurring item or per time. And also you can sort them based on a few different areas. So the real magic comes in if you go to the top right-hand corner and click Strategies. Now you'll land on this page and you can see in front of you a whole host of options. You can see here that you've got category context, smart task labels, task reminders, print list, smart list, and timers. These are some of the basics. So for example, if I switched on timers and I also switched on tags, if I go back, you'll see down at the bottom a new area has been added, and that's the timers area. Essentially, when you activate something on the strategies area, it will be created here, which is quite nice because you can basically create your own application. So as you can see here, if I click into a task and I click edit task, I can even add labels now, which I wasn't able to do before. Let's say I need to complete this one in town. That's added the tag ability there. Now, at any point, you can make it a recurring task and even add a project or turn it into a project. So you have that ability and you can even move it to a separate area and change the due date. Now, going back over to this area, you can see that, okay, brilliant. Now you can start adding stuff and you're probably going, okay, the basics seem pretty good. But there are a whole host of different areas. So for example, notes, you can add specific day notes or specific task notes. I've got task notes turned on. So for example, when I go over to film YouTube and you can see that show and hide task appear, show and hide note appear, and I can add any context that I want here. Now, if I go back over to strategies, you naturally have a different area for each different thing. So for example, with this area, you have the ability to really focus on your prioritization. So for example, if you want to assign a priority star to it, you can switch this one on. If you want to use a method called enapfrog, which is it's a Brian Tracy methodology, allowing you to put a specific tag on a task that you want to complete first, the horrible tasks. And you could even have most important projects and a back burner too. But let's say for those two demos, the prioritization, you can see at the top right-hand corner, I've got the frog appearing here. You can click edit task and here you can see all of the settings. So you can see, okay, this is a medium priority, so I'm gonna add a star to it. And it's, I don't actually know the frog scoring system, but you can, for example, put your frog as this one here. And essentially that one is the one you wanna do first in the day to get it out the way. Read the book, Eat That Frog. I've only listened to the Blinkist summary of it, but I know it's about associating frogs to specific tasks that you want to do. Now, if you go down here, there are a bit more detailed, and this specifically focuses on the time management area. So you have got duration estimates. So you can, for example, give yourself a bit of an outline of how long you're roughly gonna complete it in. You can add an agenda. So this puts actually the tasks and events in a calendar view, which will save you time and also create that like timeline view. I'm gonna put time tracking on as well. So you can actually add that. You can add a calendar too if you wanted to. Now I'm gonna add the week scheduler and let's dive back in and show you how all those work. So you can see here, it's automatically changed in terms of what you see. You see this specific agenda in front of you. And naturally you can actually go to my week as well and actually plot that out. So you can see here that you can see all the tasks that I've done up here, which is great. But if I go to my week, I can access that from there. Now, if I wanted to, I could add a specific task here. And as you can see, it's automatically added 30 minutes as a duration. So up here, you can see that there's a 30 minute sum. So for example, if I added multiple of these, for example, like I added four or five things that I had during my day in this agenda view, it would essentially calculate how long you're gonna spend in a day on tasks and when you're gonna be finished by. So that's quite a healthy way to process your tasks. Now, for example, if I just wanted to go back, I could naturally go to strategies and switch this off. If I had those existing tasks as time associated ones, I could easily have and see those there. Now, here's an area that you can add in called lists. You can have custom squares, custom sidebar, so you can design your own sidebar. You have to activate it. So some of these have activation. So for example, you have a settings menu where you can really go into editing the stuff before you use it. Okay, so when you've created a custom sidebar and you've chosen what you wanted, you can essentially choose what appears here and this allows you to customize it. So you could have your own smart lists, you could have an area for labels, and you can even drag stuff on. So for example, I did this one last month when I was originally doing this. Let's say you want to reschedule that one, shopping list for baked goods. I think we were baking a cake that day, and you can change all the details to it. And one thing I didn't show you just then as well is that I set up time tracking. So if I wanted to track a task, it will appear here and the timer has been started, and it will also indicate a report as well at the end. So if I go back to the strategies area, you can start to see that you're building up your own application. You have a sections area where you can actually set to a specific, like for example, break it down for morning, afternoon, evening, which I already had on. You also have a time blocking sections. You have time blocking abilities up at the top, so you can actually schedule out a calendar too. There are a few additional things like time savers where you can have pinned tasks and saved items like in templates. You have decision makers, which give you a random item, but for example, a random task out of your list to do, or a suggested task. So there are a few little sort of not gamification, but real prioritization things that you can do inside of this. You can also see work modes as well. So for example, if you want to beat the clock on certain timers, if I switch that one on, so when you activate the beat the clock, you have to give it a time estimate. For this case, I've got 30 minutes on here and this one starts. So for example, you can't let Marvin hit the top or else the task is not complete. So there are a few strategies in there that will help you to boost your productivity. Now, if I scroll to the bottom, these are more sort of specific ones. For example, there's a few day progress bars and day time targets. You've also got procrastination counts, staleness warnings, and a few mindset-based ones, as well as email into Marvin and Zapier integrations. Now, there are a few additional ones like the ability to do GTD-based functions like weekly review and also reward tasks. So for example, a karma-based system inside of there. And the team have let me know that they tend to add one task or one strategy per month. So they're always adding new ones. This one is a brand new one, the ability to add start dates from the last time I checked it. Now, just to give you a bit more of an overview of this application, what I would say about this application is it's not as fluid as some of the other applications. It takes a bit of time to learn. Definitely, that's why I had a call with the team, because I was like, I need to understand this a bit more, and they explained it very well. But once you understand it, and once you can be using it, it can be a very good way to start plotting out your week. Now, the real drawbacks at the moment is it's only available on web. I would say the design is a little bit clunky, but again, early days for this application, and also the price tag is pretty high. Now, naturally, with most tools, there is a free trial, but per month, this application is $12. You can pay a yearly one, which is $8, but you have to pay annually for that. There is a 50% off rate for students, and if you want to go lifetime, it's $300, a one-off lifetime cost. So this application has a few other bonuses. There is naturally search and a good resource center. There's also archive and stats. You can access all of your recurring items and smart dates. So once you're set up, it can really take you through the motions. There's also cloud sync. So for example, once they do really enhance their other applications, you do have access there. You have integrations and a lot of layout changes. Themes, you have a lot of themes, visual fonts. You can go really granular with this application in terms of making it your own, everything from sound to the abilities you do. Now, who I recommend this application for? Definitely recommend it for people who like to view in agenda view and also like to fully customize their application. Now, it's very early days for this app at the moment, but I know a lot of people have fallen in love with it, and I've seen some of the messages that you guys have sent in the Facebook group, and a lot of people have been getting on with it and really investing their time into it. So guys, that is Marvin. I'll include all of the information below. I wanted to give a shout out to SaneBox, which sponsored this month here on the Keep Productive YouTube channel. SaneBox is an email management tool. I use them as a way to reduce the amount of noise in my email, and I find it really valuable. I use it with Missive, which is another app, another email application, and I find it to be a really effective method. Now, you can get $25 discount below, so if you want to access that, you can find that there. And they also have really extensive resources if you want to understand how to use it in full. I've also done a full unlisted video below about SaneBox, so if you want to check that one out, you can below. Anyway, guys, that was my first impressions as part of the weekly series. We're going to be back next week with a habit tracker application. So if you want to check that one out, please do come back to this YouTube channel. Hit subscribe, hit like if you enjoyed it. Comment on some of your thoughts on Marvin. It honestly would be great to hear. Anyway, guys, thank you so much for stopping by today. Make sure to have a great week. Keep productive, and I'll see you guys very, very soon. Cheers.